Dopamine is a naturally occurring catecholamine. It has direct alpha and beta adrenergic effects depending on the dose. And when a dose greater than 5 micrograms per kilogram per minute is given, dopamine acts directly on the beta 1 receptors, which causes an increased myocardial contractility and increased heart rate. When used in doses of 10 to 20 micrograms per kilogram per minute, typically the alpha receptors are stimulated, which result in an increased systemic vascular resistance, in other words, vasoconstriction. Infusion rates greater than 20 micrograms per kilogram per minute may result in excessive vasoconstriction and cause tissue damage that can't be repaired. Dopamine can be very effective in treating hypotension with signs and symptoms of shock. A dopamine infusion can be titrated to treat shock associated with poor contractility or systemic vascular resistance that is unresponsive to fluid administration. Some precautions and contraindications are that dopamine could cause tachyarrhythmias and excessive vasoconstriction and should be used with caution in patients who are suffering from cardiogenic shock with associated symptoms of congestive heart failure. Now, it's important to correct hypovolemia with volume replacement before initiating dopamine therapy. So, let's look at the pediatric dosage. Dopamine should be administered via IV or IO, and its most common infusion rate is 2 to 20 micrograms per kilogram per minute. We want to be sure to titrate dosage and drip rates to the patient's response.